Hey guys, and welcome back. If you're new here, I'm Mrs. J. Roche, and I make videos centered around beauty and lifestyle, which means you'll see a little bit of fashion, a little bit of DIY, home decor, home improvement, cook with me, eat with me, all blended together into one channel. So if you're interested in seeing any of those kind of videos, make sure you hit that subscribe button before you leave. That way you never miss a future upload from me. So in today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you guys what I picked up from Sephora's winter VIB sale, which was mostly skincare with a few makeup items. So yeah, let's go ahead and jump into it. So the first thing I want to share with you guys is the Sephora Pro Palette. And this is the Editorial 2.0, which is what I use to create the makeup look that I'm wearing today. So this is what the actual palette looks like. Kind of has that iridescent vibe going on with the lettering, but it's kind of heavy. Seems to be very durable and well made. It also comes with a little card that gives you ideas for different makeup looks based on your skin tone. Here's the actual palette itself, and I think the colors are super vibrant and beautiful. So the colors that I used from this palette for today's look are these two right here, and it's Coven and Alchemy. I also picked up an Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Wiz pencil, and this is in the color dark brown. This is definitely a holy grail product for me, for sure. Like, I believe I could leave the house any day of the week without makeup as long as my brows are intact. The last makeup product that I picked up this time around is the NARS Natural Radiant Longwear Foundation. And this is medium slash dark 3 cadets. I've actually never tried this before, but my cousin told me about it. And she said it's a really, really good foundation. Not super matte or super dewy, but I guess a healthy balance in between. So yeah, I'm really looking forward to giving this a try for myself. I also picked up another pack of the Shiseido facial wipes, and you guys, after using these, I honestly don't see myself going back to the rounds that I used to get from the drugstore, because these are so worth the price. So this is what they look like. They're super soft. They don't leave my skin feeling dry, and I usually can use one of these for my entire face. So if you watched my last Sephora haul, you had to know that I was gonna repurchase this product. And that is the Amika Brooklyn Bombshell Blowout Spray. You guys, holy grail right here. So it says that you're supposed to apply this to your hair right before you blow dry it. I actually use it right before I flat iron my hair or curl my hair, and it just leaves my hair feeling so soft, you guys. I used a little bit of it today, and it's just, this is probably one of the best hair care products that I have used thus far. So this is another repeat purchase for me, and I don't know why I always have trouble saying this word, but it's the Clinique Moisture Surge Hydrating Supercharge Concentrate. This right here. So this is what it looks like outside of the box, and it is 1.6 fluid ounces, and for me it doubles as a moisturizer and primer. So I apply it all over my face right before I put on my foundation, and it leaves my skin feeling super soft. It helps my foundation to go on really smooth and flawless. And even though I use this all throughout the year, if you've never tried it, the best time to try it is now during the winter months, because that's when our skin has more tendency to be super dry. So I tried to get my hands on this during the spring sale, but they were all sold out. So I'm so glad I was able to pick it up this time around. And that is the Fresh Sugar Lip Polish. This is basically an exfoliator for your lips. So I'm definitely going to incorporate this into my nighttime skincare routine. Of course, I won't be using it every day, because exfoliating every day is not healthy for your skin, but I'll probably use this 2 to 3 times a week. So I could not decide on a facial soap, because the two that I was using the majority of the time, I love them both equally. So I bought both of them again, and that is the Origins Checks and Balances and the Clinique Foaming Facial Soap. You guys, oh my goodness. So as far as skincare is concerned, these two products have changed the game for me. It's just amazing to see the transformation that my skin has gone through since I started using these, my skin feels so healthy. It looks healthy, it feels healthy, it's soft. Okay, so you know how when you use a facial cleanser, right? And after you wash your face, your skin feels clean, but it also feels dry and cracked and flaky, just like it's been used and abused. These facial cleansers don't do that to my skin. So I also repurchased the First Aid Beauty Ultra Repair Cream. And if you've been following me for a little while now, you know that my youngest son struggled with a pretty severe case of eczema for the first 2.5 years of his life. And I actually incorporated this cream into his hair wash routine. And I am happy to say that he is completely eczema free and has been for well over a year now. If you're interested in checking out that video of his wash day routine, I will leave it linked up here as well as in the description box. I also picked up the Belief True Cream Moisturizing Balm. I've never used this before, but I've heard good things, so I'm excited about giving it a try. It feels pretty good. It's not real thick, but it's also not runny. Seems to be a healthy balance in between. Kind of has like a citrusy smell. Doesn't stink, but it's not like, oh, it smells so good. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing this right, but this is the Ole Henriksen Truth Serum, which is collagen boosted with Truth C complex. It says, Truth Serum infuses skin with potent antioxidants. This powerful serum helps brighten, firm, revive, and smooth skin. So I'm here for all of that. I also received a few samples with my purchase, and this one is the Yves Saint Laurent Magic Wand. 8 hours of beauty sleep in a click. So it looks like a concealer. And then I got 2 perfumes, Erin Amber Musk. It smells okay. I mean, it's not something that I would actually go out and purchase myself. This one is the Dolce & Gabbana Garden. Now this smells good. This really, it's kind of like a soft, it reminds me of a garden. It's like a soft floral scent. So that is it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it and were inspired to pick up a few new things. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button before you leave, and I will see you in my next video. Bye. This box is empty. Eat with me. Fellowship with me. Laugh with me. Cry with me.